Hi, everybody. Mr. Campbell with MrCampbellRocks.com here to show you how to create breakout rooms using Google Meet and Google Classroom and Google Docs and an extension called Mute Tab. This original idea came from Clay over at claycodes.org. He's created some extensions for Google Classroom. And so we're going to jump into a Google Doc first. I've already done a little bit of the work beforehand, and you'll have to do a little bit of the work before you start the class. But what we're going to do is we're going to create four rooms here, and we're going to give each one of those rooms a unique lookup ID. And the way that you can grab that lookup ID is you can just copy and paste this here, and you'll see there's a forward slash after the lookup. So I can just do that now while you're here watching. So we're going to grab this text here. Command copy. We're going to bring it over here. It's going to be highlighted. It's going to look a little bit ugly. So we want to make the text black. We want to no highlighting behind. And I'm going to pull this off. Now it looks a little bit cleaner. So I just copied and pasted that and I put it down here. And then I just renamed each one of the rooms, room one, room two, three, four, and so on. You can see that. So now what I want to do, though, is I want to add this hyperlink because this is kind of ugly, right? I want my students to be able to just click on something and go to that room. So we're going to copy this text, right? We're going to come over here to room one. We're going to highlight that text. We're going to insert a link. Well, that link is going to be room one, right? Now we're going to clean up some of this stuff. We've got our four rooms. And obviously, if you want to do this five times, you could, you know, do this 5, 10 times, however many kids you wanted in that room. And then, right, this document we want to have called breakout rooms. So we'll just call it there. I want to actually share this document with my Google Classroom. Now, before you share that with your Google Class and you divide out up, you're going to be able to give instructions and different things like that. You have to join each room so that you can see what's going on in, you know, each one of those rooms. Because as a teacher, you've got to allow those kids to come in. So what we'll do is I'm actually going to click on this and you'll see a tab opens up here. I'm going to mute myself and we'll tell you why in just a minute. We'll add that extension and use that. So I'll have four rooms here. Now there is a add-on that I have here where you can resize your tabs here. You can do 2x2, you can do 4x4. And so if I wanted to, you'll see that I can just resize them and have them here. So I could have all four meetings open at the same time. I'm not going to go through the rest of the process, but I would have four equal screens, right? And I'm obviously going to join them. So I'll just show you with these two rooms what it would look like when I join. So you'll see it says room three. Here, mute myself there. You can also turn on grid view so you can see all the kids in that group. So I would have four windows here. And again, if you have an external monitor, this would be great to put up there and you can kind of be doing stuff here. But we have this document now that we want to share in Google Classroom, right? So we want to share something with our class. It's for all students. We want to add like we normally would. We would go to Google Drive. It's going to be the most recent document here called Breakout Rooms. We're going to add that here. And then the kids, right, will have access to this document. And you could even put names next to it if you want it, next to it if you wanted. This is room one, this is room two, this is room three, this is room four. The nice thing about this extension that I was telling you about is Mute Tab, is if I want to, I can mute individual tabs so I'm not hearing all of my students jump in. And that's right here. So this tab is muted. So if all my kids are in here and I'm in this meeting and I can jump from tab to tab, and it's basically like a breakout room that you would have in class when you're moving them to different parts of your classroom or different parts of the building or different activities. It's a great way to have your kids working together in small groups that you can then monitor and maintain all at the same time. If I had 30 kids or 30 parent volunteers, I would love to do this and show you how to do this in action. But that's an easy way in less than 5 minutes to create breakout rooms for your students using Google Meet, Google Classroom, Google Docs, and the extension called Mute Tab. again, if you're here, it's because you're an educator and you're looking for innovative ways to engage and interact with your kids and have them interact with other students. I love you. I appreciate you. And I'm glad that you're here.